Welcome back to the channel, and in this video we are going to discuss few things like Linux directory hierarchy, some redirect operators, shell variables, environment variables and things like that. So in Linux, the topmost directory is called slash or the root directory. So there's no directory over the root. So if I go into cd slash, you can see I'm in the root directory now, and if I list the content, so you can see all the important directories are under the slash directory. So things like boot, proc, etc, temp, these are all important directories which are under the root directory, right? So don't confuse it with the name root. So slash is actually called the root directory because it's the root of everything. So everything originates from the slash directory. Root is basically a user, and if I do cd, I go back to my home. Like I told you last time, if you do cd, you go back to your home. And if you do pwd, you can see the root user home is under the slash directory as well. All right. Now let's talk about the shell variables and the environment variables. So shell variables are nothing. I mean, these are just variables which are used by Linux systems. You can create your shell variables and use them in your scripts. Basically, they are used for setting up some values which you are going to use in your shell or in your script, or I mean any basic operation. So it's very easy to set a shell variable. And the difference between shell variable and the environment variable is that the shell variable is for that particular shell session. So once you exit out of this shell session, the variable is no more available to you. But if it's an environment variable, then it's available to you across all the sessions, right? So let's first view the environment variable which are available to us. So you can use a command called env, and if you just run it, you can see all these variables which are already set, and they are used by system, like this variable called path. So all your commands are being loaded from these path only, and if there's a command which is outside of these path, it will not be loaded by the Linux system. So you need to explicitly call that command. So if you want your command or if you want your script to be running as a command, you need to put it in the shell path. So if you do echo $path, and one thing you must remember, to call any variable you need to put a dollar sign before that. So if you do echo $path, these are the paths basically where you need to set your command, right? All right. So if you want to set your own shell variable, the process is very simple. You can just define the variable name and set it to a value. So suppose I define a variable name hello, and I'm setting it to value hello. So now it's set. So if I want to call it now, I could just do echo $hello, and it is set. To change this variable into an environment variable, there's a command called export. So if I do hello export hello, now this variable is an environment variable. But the best place to set an environment variable is the bash rc file, so that for that particular user you always have the set of environment variable available. So how to do that is basically you go into your bash rc file, go to the end of it, and do export hello equals the value of the variable, right? And then you need to do a source on bash rc. Source is basically reloading the bash rc file. So if I do a source, I have reloaded. Now even if I exit out of this session, log back in, and do an echo on $hello, you can see I still have this variable available even when I logged out of the session and then logged back in. So in a new session basically. Now let's talk about the command path which I just referred. So command path is basically a special environment variable which your shell uses, or basically it's a list of directory structures which your shell searches to load any command. So like I showed you echo $path. So these are the directories which your shell looks for when running any command. And if it didn't find it in these directories, then it says that command is not available. A simple error's out, right? So if you have any script which you want to run as a command, you need to put that script either in one of these directories, or you need to add your directory in the path itself. So it's called adding the directory in the path. Okay. Now let's talk about the redirect operator. So Linux has basically a couple of redirect operators which you can use, I mean, which are very useful when running commands. So suppose if you want to redirect an output of a command in a file and not on the shell, you can do is, like, suppose if I do ls-lrt right now, it lists me these two files. But what if I want to redirect this into a file of its own? So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to do ls-lrt, and then I'll give a greater than symbol, and I'll give a file name, say file1.txt. And now if I do ls-lrt here, you can see a file1.txt is created. And if I view the content of this file, you can see all those output are here, right? So basically what it did is basically redirected all the output of the ls-lrt command into a file. And since file 1 was not existing, it created one. And if it would have existed, it would have just overridden all the content of that file. So in case if you don't want the content of the file to be overridden, what you can do is, instead of single greater than sign, you can do a double greater than sign. This is basically an append operation. Now we are going to talk about standard error. So sometime you will see that even if you redirect all the output to a file or to any other device, the command still prints out some message on the screen. Probably you wouldn't want that. Like, for example, if I do say ls-lrt slash some gibberish, this directory does not exist, right? And I redirect it to file1.txt. So you can see, even I have redirected all the output to file1.txt, this error got printed. Alright, like I told you, there's a third stream of data called standard error. So we have talked about standard input, standard output, and this is a third stream called standard error, and it's basically used for debugging purposes. So even if you redirect all the output to a file, they're still printing it out on the shell for debugging. So standard input, standard output, and standard error are basically represented by numbers. So standard input is 0, standard output is 1, and standard error is 2. So now if you don't want this warning or this error to be displayed on the shell, what you can do is, you can give the number which is representing standard error and redirect it to a device called dev null, so which is like a black hole in Linux. So anything you don't want, you just redirect it to this. We'll talk about the dev null devices when we'll talk about the devices itself. Alright, so now if I do this, you can see there's no error printed out on the screen, because what it did is it basically redirected all the error to a device called dev null. In case you want to send standard error and standard output to the same place, what you can do is, instead of doing dev null, you can do ampersand 1. So what this will do is, basically it will redirect the standard output and standard error to the file 1. So now if I do cat on file 1, so you can see I got the error which was there in the file1.txt. Okay, so I think this is it for this video, guys. I think we have covered all the basics of Linux, and we are good to go to some more complex stuff now. I thought two videos would be enough, but when I was going through the curriculum, I saw that I've missed a couple of things, so I thing. I thought I should cover it in another video. So now I think we are good. We have talked about the directory hierarchy. We've talked about basic commands. We've talked about redirect operators, standard error, standard input, standard output, so all the file descriptors. So now I think we are good to go, and probably we should move on with the course. So please do subscribe to my channel before moving out, and thank you for watching.